I had prepared and I had like done my own costumes and this and that and set my own look thinking this is the character. I want to be an actor and straight away goes into an audition and realizes you don't know anything about acting. That was like a very good part and I was really like ki yaar ye film ye mujhe role chahiye ye mujhe role chahiye but mujhe nahi mila tha. I was like shit yaar kya hoga aage.
Did you ever have to dance in an audition?
No. When I was giving auditions, there were rarely times I was called for a lead part. Okay. Or they were auditioning for a lead part. What was happening was...
Is that usually the case, Vicky? The fact that the lead cast is already like decided and the casting director really comes in to for the ensemble in a certain way? Or is that not
the
case?
That's what happened with me. Okay. I can't say it as to how it happens because I could be wrong.
Yeah.
But that's what happened with me. Okay. I was rarely called for lead parts. But... called at most times for hero ka dost and ye character and wo character and everything. And some of them are really good parts, like good parts in a film. And but most of the times what happens is when you're struggling as an actor, you are out of 10, the 8 auditions you're giving are for ad films. It's not for films.
Right.
Films, usually what happens is by the time the film is set up and they're really looking for a new guy and they're really scouting for a new guy, it happens like once in a year, twice in a year. Otherwise, most of the times they have their new guy ready.
Right.
They know who that new guy is and this is the film and they're making this film this with this new cast. That's already, that setup is ready.
Right.
But it very rarely happens that a film is ready, the script is ready and they know that it's going to be a new guy and now they're scouting for a new guy.
Right.
You know, like the lead.
Dangal would be an example of looking for the leads after everything is ready. I mean, you really auditioned like crazy even with films, right? Even if most of them were ads. Were there any parts that you auditioned for that we know that you auditioned for and we've seen on screen? Like some good parts that you missed out on?
Not lead parts, but yeah. I can mention like my first audition in fact was that for a friend's part in Bhaag, Milkha, Bhaag. Which that part was heavily edited out of the film eventually.
Right.
But that was for Milkha Singh and Hanit Rehan was the casting director and he was very, very sweet. Like he gave like 3 hours, which rarely is given to new actors and you know, and that was my first audition and he gave like 3 hours and he really tried to make me act. But I couldn't.
Oh.
I was a very bad, this was before theatre, this was right after being in
Delhi. Right.
I want to be an actor and straight away goes into an audition and realizes you don't know anything about acting. So that was very bad, but that was the first thing that I did. And then there was a part of this film called Ghanchakkar, which eventually Namit Das had done the role.
Right.
I still remember the character's name was Idris. I had done
again
that.
Friend, no?
Again friend.
Imran's friend.
Right. But that was a great part. Like that was like a very good part and I was really like ki yaar ye film, ye mujhe role chahiye but mujhe nahi mila tha. I was like shit yaar kya hoga aage. But then I didn't know like
but this is after you prepared yourself.
I had prepared and I had like done my own costumes and this and that and set my own look thinking this is the character and gone for the audition and properly given an audition. But that didn't happen. You know, because they found a better actor.
Sure.
So, but then, yeah. But today I feel good ki yaar achha hua nahi hua because God had different plans
had better plans for you. Right.
So,
but even Masaan would be your first release. Of course, Zuban was the first one that you signed up for. You know, honestly, as a viewer, I didn't understand the film very much.
Zuban.
Yeah, although I know that a lot of people loved it and it won the best film at Busan that year, if I'm not mistaken.
It was the
what did you think of that film? I mean, what did you make of that film that maybe we can watch it differently or it is what it is?
No. You don't have to watch. I don't feel that an audience should change the way he or she should watch a film.
Couldn't connect at all.
If you can't connect. Yeah. If you connect with something, you connect with something. The film, when I got the script, I had not done the film just because I was getting a film. It really resonated with me. It was really about a guy who was coming. It was a coming of age story of this guy who had lost belief in his faith and then comes to terms with it. I thought it was a big arc to achieve in my first film. And also knowing that culture, he was a Punjabi from Gurdaspur, goes to a big city and lives that life and eventually realizes that it's not him and now wants to connect back to his roots and music becomes his medium. So for me, there was a lot of, I really resonated with that story. For me as an actor, there was a lot to do. The journey plus that stammering, plus music, plus everything. So there was I thought, that was a great opportunity. And that's why I just plunged. Like till date, I just see something, if I feel connected for any reason, I just plunge into it. I don't think if it's going to do any good.
You went through several rounds of auditions for the
film? Many rounds. I think, firstly, for that film also, I was one of the first guys to audition for the film. I didn't make the cut. Then they auditioned some 200, 300 other guys. And then they called me back again for an audition. And this time Moses himself was taking the audition. And then he took my audition with like, he did some 4-5 rounds of auditions. They had two criteria. Firstly, apart from a person knowing how to act. Mm. But they wanted a guy who could naturally speak in Punjabi, who knew that culture of Punjab. Those were their basic criteria. So they made me do like many, many scenes till they said a yes to me. And that's how that film happened.
Even Masaan, for that matter, I think you mentioned this in an interview before about how you saw the pilot promo of that film. Yeah. And it was other people. And then you finally got that part.
Yeah.
Who were the other people who were doing that film then?
So I remember me, Neeraj, and the entire AD team of Gangs of Vasipur.
Right, that's how you know. Because you guys
work together. That's how we know each other.
Gangs, yeah.
And we were going to Pune because a friend of mine who was also an AD on Gangs of Vasipur, she had lost somebody in her family and they were from Pune and we had to go to Pune. Mm. So we were in the same car and we were just catching up after a long time.
Mm.
So he's like, kya ho raha hai life mein, kya ho raha hai? And I was like, I just shot for a film called Zuban and this and that. And so he's like, acha. So he's like, tu kya kar raha hai? So he's like, you know, I'm trying to make this film. And that time the film was called San CD Sanyasi.
Are you serious?
Yeah. Because I was like,
can you say that again?
I had the same reaction. So he was sitting in the front seat and I was in the back. So he's like, main film bana raha hu jiska naam ye hai. And I was like, huh? So he's like, so basically these are like the 4-5 things that Banaras is known for and it's like whatever, right. The elements of Banaras.
Mm.
So I was like, okay, what is this film? And he showed me the pilot promo. So he showed it to me, I was like, yeah, it looks interesting. And then he kind of gave me a gist ki iske bare mein, uske bare mein. The cast was Rajkumar Rao for the part that I played, Manoj Bajpai for Sanjay Mishraji's, Richa and Shweta were always there.
So you saw them on the screen in that film, in a promo?
Yeah.
Right,
they had,
right.
Like with Rajkumar, they had gone to Banaras and shot that pilot promo.
Achha.
Manoj sir's ka, they had taken bits from, he had taken bits from Vasipur and then put it in the film. Richa ka, I think they had shot on a Versova beach. And Shweta ka, something they had done and made a pilot promo to pitch it to producers and stuff like that. So I was like, damn cool, yeah, this looks interesting and all of that. And then he started discussing about, you know, that Masaan, that Ghat and all of that. And we were together in Banaras for Vasipur, so I knew of that milieu and stuff. So I was like, okay, damn good, cool. Then a week later, I got a call from Mukesh Chhabra's office that, you know, we want to audition you for a part in Neeraj's film. And I was like, Neeraj showed me the pilot promo and there was only one character which was of my age category. Mm. I don't know which other character, he never mentioned. I was like, okay, let me just go and figure. So when I went to the office, he told me that, you know, what needed to happen was, we had to shoot the film in the month of October when the Durga Puja happens.
Mm.
Because that Durga Puja sequence, that song sequence. I mean, the budget was so low, we couldn't have created that anywhere.
Mm.
So if they would have missed shooting that year, they would have to wait another year to get that Durga Puja again, which they couldn't afford. And I think the dates were clashing for Raj and Raj couldn't make it during that time. So basically that slot was open all of a sudden.
Oh.
Yeah. So so that's when they were looking for new actors now. So they auditioned me, I passed the audition.
That's your breakout role.
Yeah, that is.
Right?
That is.
And you owe it to Raj.
Of course.
You owe it to Rajkumar Rao. Like there are 4 or 5 actors totally competing for that slot. And
In fact, first couple of films of mine, be it Zuban also. Zuban had got to somebody else and then wo nahi ho paya. And then they started auditioning, I got the film. Masaan I got like that. Raman Raghav had gone to somebody else and phir wo nahi ho paya.
Like
and
gone to somebody else is very common, right? But like they'd shot something?
No, of course not.
Okay. Right.
I mean, no actor would leave midway. But yeah, they were in talks, positive talks, and then something happened and then...
Has the reverse happened to you often or at all? Where you're doing a particular part and then you've been removed or you've had to leave?
No.
Padmavat? Weren't you supposed to play that part?
No, but I was never given the surety that you are playing that part.
Okay.
I mean, of course, you are in talks for many different films and then... And those are talks like on a multiple level that, you know, they're also talking to like various actors at the same time and then, but those are just talks.
Sure.
It's not like
you're not signed on the dotted line
and then said that, ki yaar, aap nahi kar rahe, koi aur kar raha hai.
Correct.
So, wo nahi hua tha. So it was the same with Padmavat also that, you know, there were discussions happening ki we are looking at a possibility.
Mm.
There was look test and this and that, But then that didn't happen because at that point they wanted a bigger name and all of that, which is fair enough. You know, it's a big film, which it's a huge film, and it's a fair enough point. So that's why it didn't happen, and it's a part and parcel of the job.
Subscribe to Midday India. Get direct notifications on all our videos by clicking on the bell icon.